We've been doing this for 10 years, and sometimes you have to do something new, something fresh, so that it's always new and doesn't become
old,
the same. And sometimes to feel fresh, you have to make a change just to make sure that it's exciting and it keeps going on so that you don't wind up being a caricature of yourself, so you don't wind up being a copy of yourself. So here we are, more beautiful than ever.
What does the name KISS stand for, and what does it mean?
KISS no, KISS just stands for kissing.
Yes.
Boys and girls, yes, like that. Wet, sloppy ones, better.
What do you think most of your fans are boys?
You mean males, men, teenagers?
Fans. Yes. Your fans.
Why? Maybe they scream louder, but most of them are, but not all of them. There are a lot of girls.
Yes.
We have a lot of girls.
How does it feel to know that you're an example, a model for kids all over the world?
Tonight.
How does it feel? It feels good. We try not to tell people what to do, or how to lead their lives, or who to vote for, or which country is better than the other country. We don't care about those things. We only care about rock and roll and having a good time. It doesn't matter to me what religion you are or if you have a religion at all. KISS is about rock and roll and having a good time, not about politics.
Why are your performances so violent?
To someone who sits all day and never does anything, watches television all day, an athlete may be violent because he runs and he throws, you know, the ball, or, but that's not violence. Violence is when you do something bad to hurt somebody or destroy something, and we are not violent, we are energetic.
Do you care about war and peace and the peace movement?
I think everybody cares about war and peace.
Piece of cake is very good.
I think everybody wants peace, and everybody knows that war is bad. War kills. No one has to tell you that. When you're this big, you know that it hurts when you fall or when someone punches you, and nobody has to tell you that those things are bad.
Yin, why do you put out your tongue so often?
It helps make me girlfriend.
Do you know how long it is?
Do I know how long it is?
Yeah.
Long enough to make me girlfriends.
Shall we see?
Oh, you mean the whole thing?
Yeah.
Okay.
I understand sometimes the critics don't appreciate what you do in KISS.
That's good. The more critics don't like us, the more the fans like us.
Yeah? Is there really a connection between those two?
I think so. I think that fans can inherently spot when you're honest about something. When you try to foist something on the public, it may work for a year, it may work for 6 months. But people instinctively know when you're honest about what it is you're doing.
Mm.
It may not be popular with the critics, but people don't really care what it is that critics tell them they should like.
Yeah.
From movies, I know Star Wars all over America was panned, that it was childish and it wasn't serious, but people don't care about that. They want good entertainment.
But if you're honest, wouldn't it be wonderful if you had both the audience and the critics? The love of both.
Yeah, it would be nice.
Yeah.
Because critics are also people.
But they're not so important
critics,
for you.
No, but the critics that I don't care about are the critics who consider themselves more than people, who consider themselves, quote, above the people,
gods,
holier than thou. In other words, that they know a little bit more, and let me educate the masses, that sort of attitude. The holier than thou attitude doesn't work with me. If a critic is a person, I would love to have him enjoy the show as much as everybody else. But sometimes critics are like magicians. Sometimes magicians can't appreciate other magicians because they know too much. You don't appreciate the magic.
Excuse me, let me ask you another thing. What emotions do you like to provoke? I mean, what feelings would you like to see the audience have when they leave your concert?
I would be proud if you let us do the show and then you take your girlfriend home and you do the encores with them. I would love it if you get aroused, if your heart beats faster, if you sweat, if you forget about the traffic jam outside, if you forget that your parents or your teachers or your boss is giving you a hard time for 3 hours, if you forget about that stuff, then we've done our job. I go to soccer games and football matches for the same reason. I don't know that it means anything more than it makes you forget about your... It's a legal high. It makes you forget about your problems.
Yeah, people say that you are, you know, violent, that you are provocative, that you have the Nazi symbols and stuff like that, in spite of the fact that you are Jewish.
There's something strange in there, don't you think?
Yeah, yes, it is. I mean, how come? How come they get... I mean, you want to provoke people, don't you?
Sure.
Why?
In the same way that Beethoven... Yes, I read books.
Yes.
In the same way that Beethoven, when he saw the apathy that was existed in his time, decided to write music that wasn't Baroque and oriented. So he came out with da-da-da-da, so that people would wake up.
Yeah.
Because an audience that doesn't get either aroused or doesn't have their heart pumping more, then you as a performer have not done your job.
But why do you have a tank on the stage, Gene?
We're big boys and we like big toys.
Is that the answer?
I mean, what is it? Do you think we want to go to war with somebody?
I don't know. You know, to me, it looks like a part of the U.S. Army, parade on the 4th of July. But it's not what you are having in mind, obviously.
It's interesting that you pointed that out, because when I see a parade, I don't necessarily think of any military this or military that. But the truth is, if we've done anything to people, it's make them happy, tank or no tank. And we use all kinds of symbols that can be construed as... we use explosives during the shows. Incidentally, there are certain rules in this country that prevent us from doing the explosions, but in the U.S. tour, the tank actually fires and blows up part of the sound system, and we've got explosions all over the stage.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
Now, who in their right mind is pro-war?
Sure, sure. And that's why it's so, confusing. But
I don't think it's confusing. It's
no.
Not confusing to the fans.
Is that true?
Incidentally, why are you wearing more makeup than I am?
En grupp som förde det visuella till sin spets var Kiss, som kombinerade sin relativt enkla och melodiösa hårdrock med smink. Genrens absolut vildaste scenkläder och en show som gick utanpå det mesta.